In point-by-point calculations, what we're trying to do is find out exactly how much light, the light levels, are at a very given point. To do this, we use one of my absolute favorite math equations, the inverse square law. Every lighting practitioner should have this memorized. The good news, it is very simple. E, which stands for illuminance, is equal to CP over D squared, candle power over D squared. When light hits perpendicular to this surface, in order to find out how many foot candles we have, we measure the intensity, the candle power, at this given point, and we divide it by the distance squared. Let's have an example. If we have a 10 degree spot, it has an 11,500 candle power. At 6 feet away, six is the distance, the intensity is 11,500. 11,500 divided by six squared equals 319.4 foot candles. When we're hitting light on a not flat surface, we're hitting it at more of an angle, we have to use the cosine law. Let me try to explain this. The light intensity doesn't change, but the angle in which it's hitting someone or hitting the surface, that's going to change. And why do I say someone? It's a lot like any collision sport such as football or hockey. If an individual is coming to hit another player, what happens is that power, if you're hit it dead on, that hits full force. But what happens is the individual who's trying to get hit or going to get hit tries to move a little, changes the angle of the surface. In doing so, it diminishes the effect. However, the person is still coming with exactly the same intensity as if he hit him straight on. We use this as a cosine law. Here's an example of it. So what we do is we would use what's called a candela distribution curve. These distribution curves show us the light intensity at any given angle. If we know what the light intensity is at any given angle, and we know how far the distance is, we can quite simply just find out how many foot candles will arrive at that place. The other way that it works, the way that I love how it works, is that we don't have to pick and choose which luminaire will do the job. If we have a 25-foot high ceiling with a work cavity of 20 feet, so we're trying to throw the light 20 feet to our work plane, and we require 50 foot candles at the horizontal task, what I can do is I can use this inverse square law, change it around a little, and find out how many candle power is required to start. Let's use this as an example. If E is equal to CP over D squared, therefore CP is equal to E multiplied by D squared. CP, if we're at 50 foot candles, is 50, 20, 20 times 20 is 400. 50 times 400 is 20,000. We need to look for a luminaire that has about 20,000 candle power. That is the gist of the inverse square law, and that is why it's one of my favorite equations. Now we're going to show how the inverse square law works. We've got an LED PAR lamp with a center beam candle power of 4,800 candle power, or candela. We're going to be 4 feet away from the lamp. We measure, and we get practically 300 foot candles, which is perfect. Now, when I take my light meter and I move it from 4 feet to 2 feet, I'm halving the distance. So it should be twice as strong. However, I now have 1,200 foot candles, four times. This is the inverse square law. Now let's illustrate the cosine law. We have our same fixture here, our same lamp with the same candle power, and it's hitting perpendicular to this surface. But what happens when I take this and I angle it and I give it an angle? Notice that the beam covers a greater area, so therefore I have less light in one specific part. And that's where we use the cosine law.